45, did you hear? 45 is the new 50. The U.S. Preventative Services Task Force now officially recommending getting screened for colon cancer at age 45 instead of waiting till 50. Washington University surgeon at Siteman Cancer Center, Dr. Sean Glasgow, joins us to explain why the age was lowered. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Yeah, colon cancer, the number two cause of cancer deaths in the United States. Were those deaths increasingly occurring with younger people? Is that the reason for this?
We are seeing increased incidence of colorectal cancer in young patients, and by young, we mean younger than age 50. And that's why the task force examined the data and the evidence that was in the medical literature and decided to lower that recommended screening age to age 45.
Is this because of diet, or what's the reason for the increase?
It's really multifactorial. Diet is one factor, a more sedentary lifestyle is another factor, but regardless of the reasons, we are seeing it more frequently.
Yeah, and the gold standard has always been getting after that a colonoscopy every 10 years, unless you have a family history, and then it goes up to age 75 and beyond that. I don't believe there's much of a recommendation, correct?
Yes, that's absolutely right. After age 75, it's really should be individualized with your physician and determining whether you need to continue screening, because the benefit really is not quite there.
And before this, I believe it was maybe last year, they said African Americans should begin at 45, and now the rest of the population joins that age as well.
That's right. African Americans have been at higher risk for colon cancer, and so the screening age has always been a little bit younger for that population. Other societies like the American Cancer Society have recommended age 45 over the last several years, and now the U.S. Preventative Services Task Force agrees with that recommendation.
Oftentimes, I've been told there really aren't any symptoms for colon cancer, but there are certain things you can look for, correct?
That's right. These guidelines specifically are for asymptomatic individuals, and that's how most colon cancer is detected, if it is based on screening exams, either colonoscopy or stool studies or imaging. But some patients will have changes in their bowel movements, rectal bleeding, weight loss, abdominal pain, and that should prompt some further investigation as well.
And the insurance companies are on board with this lower age as well?
That's why this is so important. The U.S. Preventative Services Task Force affects who gets reimbursed and insurance coverage for these screening tests. And so by stating patients should get it starting at age 45, it is going to be covered. It's federally mandated for coverage.
Some good information. Dr. Glasgow, thank you so much for joining us from Siteman Cancer Center.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we wanted to let you know that Siteman has an online tool, and it will help you assess your cancer risk and suggest ways to lower it as well. You can find that at yourdiseaserisk.com. And of course, we'll have that on our website as well.